John Landis has an impressive resume. Blues Brothers.
Are you the police?
No, ma'am. We're musicians.
Animal House. Michael Jackson's Thriller. And his first job in the movies was working in the mailroom.
That was my first job in the business, yeah. But you know, they always say I worked my way up. It's not the military. You don't work your way up. I mean, you become a director because someone, in my case, my own money, but someone gives you money to direct a movie. That's all it is.
With so many hits, what does Landis call a highlight?
Well, I don't know. It's odd. I don't highlight. You know, when you make a movie, you work as hard on movies that are successful as you do on movies that are unsuccessful.
The Three Amigos!
Three Amigos was not really a big hit. And I love that movie, and I really enjoyed making it.
John Landis turned down directing one of the biggest movie franchises of the last decade.
One of my career mistakes was I turned down Men in Black.
Who went on? The last suit you'll ever wear.
When I read the script, I just went, wait a minute, this is the Ghostbusters dressed as the Blues Brothers. You owe Danny Aykroyd money. You know, they even copied that whole deadpan thing we did. The glasses, everything. They just copied it. And I was like, you owe Danny. They were not amused by that response.
You know what the difference is between you and me? I make this look good.
Wouldn't you say, though, that's a homage, a nod to you guys?
No. that's a ripoff. There's a difference.
Turns out movie making runs in the family. John Landis's son, Max, wrote the critically acclaimed Chronicle. So are you a proud dad then?
Yo, very. Are you kidding? He's brilliant. My kids, both my daughter and my son are great. It's bizarre. You look at them and you go, who are you and what have you done with my child? You know, they're these adult people. It's just very strange.
Yeah.
They become taller than you. I'm like, holy shit.
Landis also directed one of the greatest film clips of all time with Michael Jackson.
Michael on Thriller was great. He was amazing. On Thriller, he was just happy and cooperative and professional and great. I worked with Michael again 8 years later on, I made this thing Black or White. And he was not as happy, and he was really bizarre. I mean, he was on another planet by then. But I quite liked Michael. He was a sad guy, but an extraordinary talent.
So what does John Landis think of modern film clips?
I'm interested by everyone's outrage by Miley. I mean, I think it's because she was a child star. But that's no different than Madonna or Lady Gaga or any of the others. Oh, this was the Naked Girls. I never saw this.
Oh, I'm glad I can show it to you.
I heard about it.
Everyone's quite in love with her.
Well, I can see why.
I'm just really aware right now that I'm showing John Landis. I'm watching essentially porn with you.
It's not. This is hardly porn.
So what does a top Hollywood director think about the future of movie making?
It's ironic that as technology makes it easier to make a movie, it's harder to get it distributed in a theater. And I'm sad with the fact that, you know, there's generations of people who will see Lawrence of Arabia on this. Or they're, you know, that's heartbreaking to me.
Yeah, you don't get to see it on the big screen.
Oh, a movie is meant to be seen in a theater with as many people as possible. Because a scary movie is much scarier. Same is true with comedy. The more people, the funnier. It's contagious. And it just kills me that everyone's deep in their computers.